All right, it was bad. The Steelers absolutely destroyed by the Bengals, 41-10. Not one part of the team looked good whatsoever. Steelers fall to last place in the AFC North. Everything is bad. And then we read the Facebook comments.
Beware. We are going to a very deep, dark place on the internet. It's time for 96.1 KISS Facebook comments.
Facebook comments brought to us by Pittsburgh Auto Depot. These are Steelers Facebook comments after they just get destroyed by the Bengals 41-10. You know what? I'm going to start with a positive comment, okay? There's going to be plenty of negative here, but let me just start positive. Martin M., Chris Boswell is great. Team MVP. All right, there we go. Marty with the positive.
I like it.
Marty. All right, it's all bad after that, though. Patrick L., worst display of offense and defense I've ever seen. I believe the offensive coordinator is sabotaging us this season by running every first and second down to get Coach Tomlin fired. Prove me wrong. Okay, hold on.
Inside job.
You're telling me that Matt Canada is sabotaging the team this year so he can become the next Steelers head coach? That's where you are after the Steelers get destroyed 41-10 for the Bengals? All right.
He knows.
If that's where you need to be, then okay then. Rob H. here. Steelers Facebook comments. Ben is an injured horse. Tomlin needs to swallow his pride and take him to the glue factory. All right. We're taking Ben to the glue factory.
Oh, no.
Not the glue factory, man. I did not expect Ben to be taken to the glue factory in the Facebook comments. Let's go with Gus V here. Big Ben is a stupid and Bush is too. We don't need to call names, okay? Come on. You've done a lot.
We don't
need to call names. Corey H., I really hope the owner is seeing all these Facebook comments. Corey, guess what? He's not at all. I doubt Mr. Rooney even knows how to log into Facebook.
No chance.
And I definitely know he's not reading these comments. Mark F., bench them all. Ben should be in the booth calling the offensive plays, and Haskins should be giving a chance. Let him quarterback for the rest of the season with Ben calling the plays. All right, so hold on.
Did Ben just become a coach?
Ben just became the offensive coordinator.
Wow.
Well, that's what's good. So
does
here
it work like that?
Hold on. Here's what's happening. Matt Canada, the offensive coordinator, is sabotaging the team so he can become the next head coach, and then Ben will be his offensive coordinator, and Dwayne Haskins is your Steelers quarterback. That's where we are. Louis A., Tomlin, Canada, and Butler are the three stooges. Whoa! Let's calm down there, Louis. These are more Steeler Facebook comments after they get blown out by the Bengals, fall to last place in the AFC North. Rob T., once upon a time, Art Rooney gave his kids the keys to his finely tuned Mercedes. Years later, that car is hardly recognizable. These aren't my Steelers.
Oh, yeah, my Steelers.
Stephen M., worst team since 1998, 1999 under Cowher, and he had Kent freaking Graham as the quarterback. Jeff P., let's look at the bright side. Seats are getting much more affordable. The off season, which may have officially started today, will be just absolutely filled with rumors of new players and new coaching possibilities. And the Pirates are somehow not looking out of place in Pittsburgh anymore. All right, listen. Listen, I don't want to be too negative here. Are we heading to a place in the next 3 to 4 years in Pittsburgh sports where the Steelers and the Pens stink and the Pirates somehow have reloaded with young players and are good? Are we about to enter a Pittsburgh alternate reality where the Steelers and the Penguins are like, maybe they'll make the playoffs, but are the Pirates going to eventually take over here? And like, are we going to have like a few? It's a lot to think about, right?
It's a lot to think about today.
All right, we'll continue here. More Steelers Facebook comments after they're blown out in Cincinnati. Ed G., I've been on the waiting list for season tickets for about 30 years. If Tomlin is the coach and I finally get my call to buy season tickets, I will disrespectfully pass. Wow. I mean, you don't have to be disrespectful to the Steelers ticket person who's calling you, you know?
Disrespectful.
I mean, you're on the list. If you get your call, just pass, but do it respectfully. The ticket person doesn't coach the team, okay? James R., I was never a Tomlin hater, but this dude has crapped the bed. Oh, no, Coach Tomlin bed crapping.
Uh-oh.
One of the worst teams I've seen in my 40 years of Steeler fandom. Heinz Field on Sundays for the rest of the season will be lucky to rival the Whippeel crowds that were there on Saturday. Richard C. stopped watching years ago because I knew after the one for the thumb, the run was over. It really makes you appreciate what Cower did with Brister, O'Donnell, Graham, and Cordell. I mean, doesn't really he won a Super Bowl. Mike Tomlin won a Super Bowl. Does it really make you appreciate Coach Cower? Does Coach Tomlin and the team stinking so far this year? Does it make you yearn for Bill Cower, and why?
I love that he stopped watching years ago, but he's still up in these Facebook comments.
I know. Sure. You still care. You still care. All right, more Steelers Facebook comments. let's go with Frank C. here. Frank C., the Steelers have a de facto make-believe CEO who's more concerned with politics than building a winning football team. Maybe Mr. Rooney should stop worrying about his bulging bank account and start worrying about the Steelers. And if Mr. Rooney doesn't have time for the Steelers, he needs to pack his bags with Tomlin. Oh! There goes Mr. Rooney!
I think that's the first.
Send Mr. Rooney to the crossroads. Has never happened before. Usually it's just Tomlin or Ben. Gonna miss Mr. Rooney, and I'm gonna miss Mr. Rooney. Wow, Mr. Rooney sent to the crossroads. We'll end here with John F. This defense is thinner than single-ply toilet paper. You can never get a good wipe with that.